Colleagues, good morning, everybody. Sorry for the name of the site. I am from Hungary, working in the National Museum in Hungary, and I will shortly talk about one of the most important Upper Paleolithic assemblages excavated in the near past in Hungary. The site is lying close to the Slovakian border in northern Hungary, at the shallow of the Danube River. During the very limited excavations carried out by Viola Dobosi, three discrete, spatially demonstrated settlement spots were excavated. The artefacts were recovered in a very thin artefact bearing layer with very thin, not constructed hearths, without any traces of dwelling structures or pits or like this. We can interpret the Mogyorósbánya assemblages as traces of temporary hunting camps. In lithostratigraphic point of view, the artifact bearing layer was excavated in a humic horizon in an embryonic soil, widely distributed in the Carpathian basin, probably the same as was described by Paul Ezard's code as the Grugraben oscillation. It is generally dated to 20,000 BP by radiocarbon methods, and accordingly the two radiocarbon dates from made on charcoal samples collected from fireplaces in Mogyorósbánya dates the site exactly to the same period of the late glacial maxima. The lithic industry was performed basically on locally available materials, partly of Cretaceous chert pebbles and partly of other pebbles collected from the alluvial deposits of the Danube River. Because of these formations, both the Cretaceous and the Pleistocene pebble outcrops are widely distributed in the landscape. It is not possible to say that this or that piece was collected at 5 km, 10 km, or 15 km from the site. We call it generally as a locally available raw material. In the following, I will talk more deeply about two extra-local rock types. One of the obsidian and the other one is, we call the northern silicite. Earlier they were called as flint types, imported to the Carpathian basin from the region lying north of the Carpathian chains. Obsidian is a very popular topic of petroarchaeological study. In eastern Slovakia and northeastern Hungary, there are very well-characterized obsidian sources. In the Mogyorósbánya assemblage, mainly the Slovakian types, the transparent or translucent obsidian types were used. More than 230 pieces were excavated, and the Hungarian sources were less popular, or the pieces from the Hungarian sources were less popular in this site. The northern silicite collected most probably from the southern Polish region are more problematic in terms of the source identification. In the oral tradition of the Paleolithic archaeologists in Hungary, all the blue patinated excellent quality raw materials were called as flint or erratic flint in the past decades. This type of rock is found in the middle Pleistocene, dominantly in the middle Pleistocene glacial deposits in southern Poland and partly Moravia. The white line shows the southernmost extension of these moraine deposits. Some pieces excavated in Mogyorósbánya, however, bears a different cortical part as one would suppose in the case of erratic flints. After the cortical part and the banded structure of the siliceous rock, I would suppose that these species were imported to the site from the southern, from the northern part of the Krakow-Częstochowa plateau, where the Jurassic banded silicite was recently described. Another type is rather easy to identify, at least on macroscopic level. It is very similar to the classical Jurassic silicite known from the Cracovian region, not only on macroscopic level, but also on the low magnification stereomicroscopic photographs showing very characteristic fossil remains. There are two other rock types which are not known, neither from the archaeological collection nor from the geological outcrops of the Carpathian Basin. One of them is this very spectacular banded patinated rock, which I originally suspected as coming somewhere from the chocolate flint territory, but after a consultation by Dr. Schiesta from the Brno University, the possibility of identification with the Menelithic flint has also arose. Another type is very similar to the Tevel type flint, known from the middle of the Transdanubian territory. However, in this case, the fossil remains practically exclude this identification. There are a number of other gray flint or gray chert types known from the Central Europe, the Stranská skála type chert, the Jurassic type chert, type G. For the time being, it is not possible to point the exact source determination. In the archaeological assemblage, there are very characteristic occurrence of these raw materials. The pieces were introduced to the site partly as cortical flakes, large cortical flakes, partly as coarse, and partly as ready-made tools like this beautiful flint and scraper. In technological point of view, the most important thing is the presence and the large number of single platform cores, which were reduced only even on the side. So we have direct refits of the blade reduction on these long distance raw materials. Among the typological classes, burins are dominating, partly made on retouch tools. It is very typical that end scrapers were rejuvenated or formed as a buren. On the side, there are many refits, not only of flint or northern silicite and obsidian, but also of the locally available raw materials. And the cortical flakes, the large cortical flakes, were also formed for burins or for burin cores on the side. In my view, both these thick burins and the bladelet cores were used basically for producing very tiny bladelets and burin spurs, which were later worked for partly for backed bladelets, partly for backed points, and retouch bladelets. During the excavations, no wet sieving was practiced. However, there is a large number of bladelets, and these worked secondary modified blends that we can state that one of the most important point of the Mogyorósbánya assemblage is the bladelet production and the miniature or very small belt artifacts. Concerning the most important extra-local raw material sources, there are some assemblages which were excavated and partly published, dating more or less to the same period as the Mogyorósbánya site. The obsidian region is a vine region, traditionally very intensively cultivated by agricultural methods. That is why it is very problematic to find intact Pleistocene sediments. There are a large number of surface scatters dated on typological ground to the same, more or less to the same period as the Mogyorósbánya site. They are epigravettian or early epigravettian surface scatters. In some cases, like Kasov 1 in Slovakia and Arka in Hungary, it was possible to find and to document in situ archaeological artifact bearing layers during the excavations. However, after the publication, the typological and technological composition of these assemblages clearly differ from the Mogyorósbánya site. The eastern territories, no pebble raw material was utilized, mainly the block and nodular raw materials were preferred, and there is very few traces of bladelet production or bladelet backing. The territory lying in southern Poland is another problem. There are a number of assemblages which are very crudely or very largely dated to the epigravettian period, but no radiocarbon dated assemblage is known until now from that region. Probably during the LGM, this part of the continent or Central Europe was not inhabited at all. Concerning the raw material acquisition areas, for the time being we have absolutely no data or no secure data about the raw materials transported to Mogyorósbánya from the southern direction, and very few data are available from the western direction. Of the 8,000 pieces excavated in Mogyorósbánya, there is a single rock crystal which is supposed as having transported from the Eastern Alpian territories from more than 400 kilometer to the site. The Bakony type radiolarite and the Tevel flint is very questionable, the occurrence of the Bakony type radiolarite and the Tevel flint is very questionable in the Mogyorósbánya assemblage. The regular raw material transport, regular and systematic raw material transport is evidenced from the northeastern and northern direction, partly from the obsidian region and partly from the southern Polish territories. It is systematic in each assemblages excavated in Mogyorósbánya. Both type of raw material is present in different ratios, with a maximum ratio of 7% of obsidian and 5% of flint or northern raw material. The distance of this raw material acquisition is more than 200 kilometer, but generally less than 270 kilometer. In the first publications on this site, the presence of crude flint was also mentioned by the excavator. Crude flint is found very, very far from Mogyorósbánya, more than 600 kilometers in the northern part of Romania, out of the Carpathian chains. During the recent analysis, I was not able to identify a single piece which can be securely linked to this raw material source. So that is why that it the proved flint is indicated by a large question mark on this map. In my opinion, in this case, we are faced with the direct acquisition, raw material acquisition in the Mogyorósbánya site, and probably partly from a region which was not inhabited in that time, namely from the southern part of Poland. There are no data of archaeological site. But one of the refits clearly document the connection between two spatially well separated settlement spots in Mogyorósbánya. One of the pieces of this refit group was found in settlement spot 3, and two other ones around the radiocarbon dated hearth of settlement spot 2. There are a lot of possible interpretations concerning the contemporaneity of these features. Now I would stress that it is partly possible that the humans in Mogyorósbánya used the nearby archaeological site as a secondary or tertiary raw material source. During their everyday activities, they pick up good quality raw materials, good quality pieces, even not modified blades or retouched tools, and they brought to the site which they actually inhabited. Even on a larger scale, it is possible that the northern origin, the so-called flint, the raw materials of northern origin, were not collected on their original occurrence, geological occurrence. In the western Slovakia, in the Váh Valley, there are a lot of late Gravettian sites where these northern rocks, erratic flint and Jurassic flints, Jurassic silicite, were intensively used. It is a possibility that these Pebble Gravettian people living in the AGM did not cross the Carpathian chains, only they found an abandoned or eroded archaeological site somewhere closer to their original site. For the time being, the analysis of the Mogyorósbánya assemblage is still ongoing. So this is only a question or a theory which I can't solve for the time being. And thank you for your attention.